So look into whether they've collaborated with influencers before. I think that's always very important to look at. Also look at obviously whether they're a big brand, a small brand, how long they've been in. Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have another, I guess like business related video for you guys, but this is actually quite requested after I did my social media Q&A and talked a little bit about working as an influencer, but it's also just something that I get questions about all the time, like through my DMs from other girls who are trying to become bloggers or trying to start an Instagram and build a following. But essentially, the question is, how do you get brands to work with you? So I actually, probably prior to this year where I started to take my business a little bit more seriously, never really thought of it as a formula. I think I've mentioned this in another one of my videos, but I used to never really pitch to brands or reach out to brands. My outreach was pretty much zero, whereas I always, all the collaborations that I've worked on, I've always just waited for brands to come to me. But since the beginning of this year, when I wanted to just really, I guess like put more effort into building my brand and building my social and making it into a sustainable business, I started to explore, you know, outreach, pitching, what's the right or wrong way, what works for me, building a media kit, all of that. So since then, I've really tried to map out like exactly what I do so that I could write about it and talk about it with you guys. I actually already have a blog post around this topic that's live on the blog right now, so if you guys want to check that out, I will have that linked in the down bar for you guys. Getting a brand to work with you, I've pretty much separated it into four distinct kind of like parts or steps. There's the pre, the action, the post, and the follow through. And I feel like this is applicable in any sort of like business pitch you're trying to do, when you're trying to acquire any sort of clients, whether you're a freelancer, a creative, a musician, a photographer, whatever it is, or if you're an influencer like me. These are kind of, I think, can be translated into whatever area of work that you're doing. So anyways, that's enough of me rambling. If you guys want to see my kind of like formula on how to get brands to work with you, my pitching, my media kit, all of that, then keep on watching. So the first step I call the pre-step, but essentially for me as an influencer, the pre-step is trying to turn cold leads into warm leads. And if you're doing this in business, you could be going to networking events where you think that some of these clients might be attending, going to trade shows, talking to them, all of that. But for me personally, because I am talking about the social media realm, that means following the brands that you want to work with on social, liking their photos. If you already, like for example, for fashion bloggers, if you already wear their clothes, tag them in the posts, tag them in stories, DM them, just really try to engage with them on social media before you even reach out for the first time. Because once you've built up a little bit more of a relationship with them, rather than having them as quote unquote a cold lead, it's gonna make it a lot easier for you to sell them your content idea or for you to get an in with that company. Especially if it's a big company, sometimes I catch myself thinking like, hey, how come these girls who might even have like smaller followings than I do or who have been in the game for not as long as I have been are getting these crazy brand deals with companies and brands that are absolutely huge? And that's when you kind of start to doubt yourself. You're like, is my content not good enough? Is my brand not good enough? Like, what could it be? But what you have to realize sometimes is that it's not because of you. It's totally not you. It's just because the social media world is so saturated that honestly the company just probably doesn't know who you are. So what do you do about it? Engage with them. Put yourself in front of their eyes as much as possible, whether that's through tagging, like I said, tagging them in the photo, adding them on your description, tagging them in stories. Stories are great because when you mention a brand in your stories, that automatically gets put in their DMs. So that's amazing. Make sure you're engaging with their posts, liking their posts, commenting on their posts. pretty much do the most so that these brands that you want to work with will get to know your social media handle, get to know your profile, and hopefully when you send in your pitch finally, they're gonna be like, hey, I recognize that name. She really loyally follows her account. She engages a lot. She wears her clothes. She tags them. She posts them. So it'll already kind of leave a good first impression before you can even sell them your big first impression. The second step is kind of the biggest step, and it's what I call the action step. But within this step, I've broken it down into several different little steps that you can take. So first things first, you wanna do your research. This is a step that I actually learned from Vernice, and this is something that she does and she swears by. But essentially, before you even pitch to a brand, before you decide to send them your first email, whatever it is, you want to really research that company and see if their brand aligns well with yours. A lot of the times you can just think like, oh, hey, fashion, there we go. Or hotel, traveler, that works perfectly. But really look into kind of their target audience, their content type, before you decide whether you guys are a good fit to work together or not. So for example, if you're targeting a fashion brand that you yourself thinks is very gorgeous, very elegant, very timeless, but your audience are people who are your age, so for me that would be like 18 to 24 or 24 to 30, but they're targeting a way older audience. They're targeting more sophisticated women between ages of 30 to 40 or 40 to 50, then honestly, there's not gonna be that much of a reason for them to wanna work with you unless they're specifically running a campaign where they're trying to target a new audience. So look into whether they've collaborated with influencers before. I think that's always very important to look at. Also look at obviously whether they're a big brand, a small brand, how long they've been in the game. If they have worked with influencers before, look at who they've worked with and whether their content, their audience, is similar to yours. You'll want to take all of this research into account when you're crafting your pitch as well, because it's really gonna show that you're not another blogger who's just there to ask for free stuff, that you're actually trying to provide some value to their company. In this research process, this is actually the perfect time for you to actually go in and assess what their gaps are as well. So what are they missing in their content? Maybe they've worked with a lot of influencers on Instagram, but they haven't really tapped into YouTube yet. YouTube is a huge market and is definitely something that I think brands should look at when they're working with influencers. So maybe you're stronger on YouTube and you're not as strong on Instagram, but that's exactly what they're missing in their content. You could reach out and kind of use that as your unique selling point. After you've done all of your research, it's time to finally craft your pitch. And this part is so important. This itself could be an entire other video. It could be such a long video. I could go into so much detail, but I am not going to because I don't think the pitch isn't necessarily my strongest point in this process. So I've linked below a video that Vernice sent me when I was asking her for advice, which is a video by Sawyer Hartman. I think he explains the pitch process really, really well and has some really important points to remember when you're crafting your pitch. So I'm gonna link that down below for you guys. Make sure you watch that video after you watch this video because it is honestly so priceless, it's so important. But yeah, after all of your research, you want to write your pitch email. Think of this as like you're applying for a job, or if you've worked as a freelancer before, think of this as trying to acquire a new client. Don't have that mindset where you're just thinking like, hey, I like this brand's clothes and I want free clothes and I'm gonna pitch them. Really try to put yourself in kind of like a business owner mindset, and think about what you're really providing to the brand. Because yes, you're providing coverage and that's amazing, but you really have to get that across to a brand. So as much as you're asking for, you know, whether it's money or products in return, you wanna let them know what you're gonna give them in exchange. So in your pitch, you should be talking about who you are, why your brand aligns with their brand, what value you're gonna provide, and then you want to back all of that up with your statistics. So whether that's how engaged your following is, how big your following is, maybe it's just like the variety of social media coverage that you'll be able to provide them, or maybe it's just that you could provide them original content to use on their website, on their own social. Whatever that is, this is your chance to show that company that you can actually provide them value and that it's going to be worth it for them to collaborate with you. A very important part of your pitch email is that you're going to want to attach a media kit. So I kind of see media kits as like sprucing up your application package. I went to business school, I went to BCIT here in Vancouver, and when we were applying for internships, and especially because we're in like a creative field, we're in marketing, it was stressed to us by our teachers that your application package should not only be impactful with its data, it should be impactful with how it looks as well. So think about it, what's gonna make you stand out amongst all the other applications, all the other bloggers that wanna work with that brand? I think your media kit and how it looks and how it displays all of your data is so, so important because it's a window to your design skills, to your content, to your brand for the company that you want to work for. And designing a good media kit really puts you ahead of other bloggers who are just submitting their data via email. Something I've been working on personally is actually designing media kits for you guys. So I'm going to have the link down below in the down bar, but essentially I've created two media kits, two different styles of media kits that I am selling on my website. So I've got a clean white one here and then a more kind of like magazine editorial one that has a bit more of like a black bolder color to it. And these are selling on my website for $10 each. With each of the designs, you will get a two-page media kit, either in a PDF format, an InDesign format, or a Word format, so you can edit it whether or not you have a tool like InDesign or not. You guys totally don't have to buy these at all. If you want, you can just go onto that link and look at the samples I have for those media kits and totally build it out by yourself. If you're somebody who doesn't really have those design skills, don't have the tools to build it, you can feel free and purchase these. So yeah, those are available. I also actually have a third, I guess, like package that I'm offering on my website where I go in and fill in your media kit for you. So in this package, I'm going to be essentially personalizing a media kit for you. You get to pick your design out of the two and then just email me all of your stats, all of your social media handles, the numbers, your price rate, what you want your pricing to be, and I will fill it in all for you and send you back a clean, nice PDF for you to send out to brands. So again, that link will be in the down bar for you guys if you want to check it out. But yeah, the third step is the post pitch, I guess it's called. But what I like to do, because I'm a little bit of an organizational freak, is that I like to create a tracker for all of my pitches. So I actually just created mine in Google Sheets. You can do it in Excel. I find that it's the easiest because you can actually calculate like formulas within Google Sheets, and you can create like if statements, conditional formatting. It's great. It's like honestly my crack. I love it. But essentially, I created a spreadsheet for me to track all of the brands that I pitched to, so all the brands that I reached out to, the status of the outreach, so whether it's been accepted, when it's been declined. I also put in three rows for follow-ups, just because I want to send out the email the first time. That's the first row. The second row is going to be my first follow-up, and then the third row is going to be my last follow-up. And that just kind of keeps me on track, and I check it every week just to make sure, am I on track with all of my follow-ups? You want to make sure you follow up to your pitches. If a company has not replied you, follow up in a week and just be like, hey, bubbling this email back up in your inbox, hope you've seen it and hope I hear from you soon. Because a lot of the times, just because a company doesn't reply you after your first email, it doesn't mean they don't want to work with you. It just means they forgot to reply, didn't see your email. There's so many reasons why that could have been. So always remember to follow up. I found that sometimes it takes up to like the second or like my last follow-up for companies to reply, and they're always really appreciative that I followed up and that I'm taking responsibility and kind of following through with that pitch. I also put kind of like a verdict column where I can just leave comments. So in there, I will write down if a brand rejects me and they give me a reason, I'll write down that reason. If they approve it and are moving forward with a campaign, I write down what the campaign is, why they approved it, when they approved it, all of that. And this is a great document for you to look back on and to look at your failed attempts, and it gives you the opportunity to analyze, you know, what you could have done wrong or what you could have done better in this situation. Also, for all of your failed pitch attempts, don't fret. It doesn't mean that you can never work with that company. I honestly also like to keep track of all of my pitches, because in a few months to a year's time, I might send out another pitch, especially if it's a big company. They always have different campaigns running. The budget is always fluctuating for marketing. So maybe they don't have the budget for you now, but maybe at the start of a new season or right before the start of a new season, they're gonna have a refreshed marketing budget. So reach out to them again, reach out to them in the next season, reach out to them in a year when your brand has grown more. I never see the rejections as true rejections. I just see them as not right now. So yeah, just something important to keep in mind. The last step of my little process is the follow-up or the follow-through. So I've already talked about following up to your pitch emails, but I want to talk about what happens when you get the brand deal. If you've gotten the campaign or the brand deal that you're pitching, great, I'm so proud of you, you're doing so well, but what now? Obviously, you want to execute this campaign flawlessly, because the better you do at this campaign, it's gonna put you top of mind for future campaigns with that company. Make sure you keep your communication so good all throughout the campaign. Like, over communicate. I can't stress that enough. Over communicate, because honestly, this brand is probably not just working with you solely. They probably are managing so many influencers, and it's so easy for emails, communication to get lost in the process when they're talking to that many influencers. So something that I found really works for me and that I've been praised for by brands that I've worked with or by companies that I've worked for, like outside of my influencer job, is that I over communicate and people love it. As an influencer, what this looks like is once they've accepted my campaign or my proposal, I ask them for the contract right away. That's such an important tip, honestly. Ask for your contract right away so that you can make sure that this campaign is a go. I don't consider a campaign approved until I've signed my name on the dotted line, because that's when you know for sure there's no going back. This company is ready to work with you. As soon as I get that sent out, I'm like, hey, what are the posting dates look like? What are the guidelines? Do you have a creative brief for me? Once I've created my content, I send it right back to them. What do you think? Do you have any suggestions for me? Can I change anything, or is it good to go? Once I've posted my content, I'm like, hey, here's the live link. Hope you guys enjoy. And once I've hit like a 24-hour mark or a week-long mark, I'm like, hey, here are the analytics to that post. What do you guys think? How did you think I do? How is this in comparison to like past campaigns? I really, really try to over communicate, because I honestly think it's gonna make you stand out, because I feel like not a lot of people do it, which is absolutely wild. I don't see why you wouldn't. I feel like I say this a lot, but honestly, do the most. It may seem kind of extra and unnecessary at times, but do the most and get in the habit of doing the most, because you never know when a big company, when a marketing manager is gonna really appreciate that, because nobody else does it. After you've completed your campaign, make sure you send a thank you email. Even if they reject your proposal, your initial pitch, send them a thank you email being like, hey, thanks for taking the time out to read my pitch. I hope we can work together in the future. I try to be extra nice, like overly nice in my emails, even the emails where I'm like, hey, my payment is due, it's been late for a week, can you please send it through ASAP? I still end it with a, hey, I hope you're having an amazing week, or hey, I hope you have an amazing weekend, talk soon. I think it's important to always make sure that you're being professional and that you're just being nice, because sometimes in this industry, people just aren't. Which is so bizarre because we're working at a very like public facing job, yet some people that I've met, influencers or even like people who manage brands, are just not nice, and I just don't understand why it has to be like that. So be nice, be professional, and do it even in your emails, because that's really gonna make you stand out as well. I've been making it a goal to build longer term relationships with the brands that I work with, meaning I'm gonna try to work with them again and again and again. And I think that's super important if you are trying to work with brands, if you're trying to acquire brand deals, because that's what a lot of brands are looking for nowadays. Yes, they still have the one-off campaigns where they just wanna pay you, get a post out, done. But you're gonna seem even more credible to other brands when you can show that you've worked with the same brand again and again for multiple campaigns, because it shows that one, you're somebody that they want to work with, but also two, that you're responsible and organized enough that you can manage longer term relationships and campaigns. So yeah, kill your pitch, kill your campaign execution, kill your follow-up, and I have no doubts that you will do great and that brands will want to work with you again and again. All right, those are all of my tips and tricks that I've kind of picked up from, honestly, trial and error. Trust me, I've been rejected so many times that I've honestly lost count, but within 10, 20, 30 rejections, you're bound to get that one company who is happy to work with you. Another tip is if you're solely focused on working with bigger companies and you keep getting rejections from those bigger companies, maybe switch your focus and target smaller companies as well, because a lot of small companies haven't quite tapped into that influencer market, influencer marketing yet. So a lot of the times it's gonna be a lot easier for you to show them your value rather than to show it to a company who has been working with like Ami Song and Negan Marcelli already. Do you know what I mean? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. If you guys have any more questions, any detailed questions, or any questions around this topic at all, hit me up in the comment section, hit me up on Twitter. My Twitter handle is @angel.hng, or DM me on Instagram. I love chatting with you guys via all of these ways. Let's keep an open conversation going. Let's help each other grow in this industry. I think there's room for everybody. I think everybody can do well in it. So yeah, hit me up. Anywho, I hope you guys are having an amazing day wherever you are in the world, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. And you're not as strong and when you're bring them I don't